Well, a blessed good morning to all of you under the sound of my voice. Welcome to Moments of Inspiration with your friend, Minister Rick, coming to you from Hatchet Bay Lutheran in the Bahamas. What a beautiful day to be alive. My mockingbird is welcoming in the morning. The chickens are crowing and God is good. Today, I want to talk to us on a subject called science. In Bob Marley's song, Wake Up and Live, he quotes, "Life is one big road with lots of signs." Yeah, Minister Rick listens to Bob Marley. So when you're riding through the ruts, don't you complicate your mind. Flee from hate, mischief, and jealousy. Don't bury your thoughts. Put your vision to reality. And then the chorus says, wake up and live. And this morning, that's what we need to do. We need to wake up and live. Life really gives us lots of signs every day. There are street signs everywhere we go. In fact, every street has a sign. If the street doesn't have a sign, then we're lost. We're in trouble. We can't find that street. And many of those streets are named after famous people. I have seen the name Dr. Martin Luther King Drive in every city in the USA where I've been. There are stop signs. There are no entry signs. There are one-way signs, wrong-way signs, dangerous curve signs, road slippery when wet signs, left turn only signs, right turn only signs, miles per hour signs, no overtaking signs, dead end signs, exit signs, 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 signs everywhere. When you're driving in the States from city to city, there are signs that tell you where the next rest stop is, where the next gasoline station is. Yes, signs are everywhere. There's a sign that used to be on the highway in Nassau called, and it said, "Undertakers love overtakers." It's a funny sign, but it's true. Undertakers love overtakers. I saw a sign in a graveyard once that said, "People are dying to come in here." Everywhere we go, there are signs. The question is, are we paying attention to these signs? At school, there are signs telling us where the bathroom is, walk slowly, have manners, etc. On our jobs, there are signs telling us how to respond, how to act. In the airports, yeah, if there wasn't signs in the airport, we would be in trouble. At the park, at the swimming pool, the depth of the water, no diving. Yes, and some of us still don't pay attention. At the mall, there are signs. These signs give us direction and tell us where to go. In our cars, there are signs in our cars. The radiator has a sign telling us how much coolant to put in it. The oil and the transmission dipstick have signs on them telling us when the transmission or the oil is low and how much oil or transmission to put in that. The shift has a sign telling us where to find park, reverse, neutral, or drive. The radio has signs telling us where the radio stations are. The dashboard has signs. Temperature gauge, oil gauge, gasoline gauge. And yes, people run out of gas. People burn their engines up because they don't pay attention to these signs. Then there's the check engine sign. And almost every car I know has this sign on says, check engine. We just don't pay attention to signs. Many people have lost their vehicles because they didn't pay attention to the signs. Listen to me. Our bodies give us signs. We get tired. We get sleepy. We get hungry. We feel pain. And most times when our body gives us pain, it is giving us a message. Something is wrong. Go check the doctor. I'm having pain. But you know what? Some people don't pay attention to these signs, and they take sick and they die. Let me conclude this. God gave us a sign when he was going to save the world. In Isaiah 7 and 14, it says, "Therefore the Lord himself will give you a sign." Yes, God gave us a sign. "Behold, a virgin shall conceive and bear a son and call his name Emmanuel." And Emmanuel means God is with us. Yes, Emmanuel is here. The shepherds, the wise men, Bethlehem, Calvary are all signs of his appearance. Emmanuel is here with us. He came to seek and to save that which was lost. That's you and that's me. Are you paying attention to Emmanuel? Are you listening to what Emmanuel is saying? We see death every day. And that too is a sign. Yes, death is a sign that we will not live forever. Are you paying attention to the sign of death? Listen, signs of the times tell us that Jesus Christ is soon to come. Are you watching these signs? Yeah, you. Are you paying attention to these signs? Let me tell you, you should be. Here's the big question. Are you ready for the coming of the Lord? Signs are indicating that he's soon to come. Please, pay attention to these signs today. Selah, think and act on these things. God bless you today.